Good morning, everyone. We are from Group 4. We will present our material about control of pest of avocado and cocoa. But before we start, let me introduce my group. They are Muhammad Dafairda, student number 104, Karen Skizalkiel Putra, student number 108, Putra Siad Dharma, student number 109, Margite Romero, student number 809, Carol, and Alina. Next. The topic of the presentation is number one, avocado and cocoa. Number three is main pest in avocado. Number four, controlling pest in avocado. Number five, main pest in cocoa. Number six, controlling pest in cocoa. Next. The first is avocado. Avocado or Persea Americana mill belongs to Lawrence family, is originate from lowland and highland tropical America region. Avocado plant was introduced to Indonesia in 1750 by Spanish. In horticulture, avocado plants are grouped into three regions. Those are Mexican, Guatemalan, and West Indian. The following is the classification of avocado. The kingdom is Plantae, subkingdom Trachobionta, subdivision Spermatophyta, division Magnoliophyta, class Magnoliopsida, subclass Magnolidae, order Laurales, family Lauraceae, genus Persea, and species Persea Americana mill. Next. The next is cocoa. Cocoa or Theobroma cacao L is the one of the plantation commodities that is suitable for smallholder plantation because the plant can flower and bear fruit through the year. So it becomes a source of income every 6 months. Cocoa plants originate from tropical rainforest areas in South America. Cocoa development in Indonesia has started since the early of 1980s and its development is currently very rapid. The classification of cocoa plants is as follows. Kingdom Plantae, division Spermatophyta, class Dicotyledoneae, order Malvales, family Stechuriaceae, genus Theobroma, and species Theobroma cacao L. Next. The next is main pest in avocado.
The first pest is Amorbia cuneana or Western avocado leaf roller. Western avocado leaf roller family Totricidae is a primary pest of avocado. It occurs in most California groves and occasionally increase dramatically and causing several fruit damage. Amorbia feed in nest of leaves and fruit tied together with silk. When disturbed, Amorbia and orange totric larvae often wriggle violently and drop. Next. Then avocado brown mite or Oligonicus punicae. Persea mite is a key pest of California brown avocados. Avocado brown mite. Avocado brown mite and six spotted mite are sporadic pests. Several beneficial mites are important predator of pest mites and certain insects. Avocado brown mite family Tetranychidae is dark brown, oval, and tiny, about 0.01 inch or 0.3 millimeter long. Its tiny amber-colored eggs have a short projecting stalk and low numbers. Most eggs are laid singly along the midrib. Eggs are increasingly found throughout the upper leaf surface as mite numbers increase. Next. The next pest is avocado thrips or Sciurtothrips perseae. Avocado thrips, order Tisanoptera, is a key pest that scars fruit. Adult lay eggs hidden inside the underside of leaves in young fruit and in fruit petioles. The thrips then develop to larval and to pupal stage. The first instar is white to pale yellow. The second instar is larger, more robust, and bright yellow. Larvae are typically found along Meyer veins on the underside of young leaves and anywhere on the surface of young fruit. Next. Greenhouse thrips are Helioptris hemorrhoidalis. Greenhouse thrips are the Tisanoptera, occurs primarily on broadleaf evergreen plants including avocado, citrus, and many ornamentals. Adult greenhouse thrips are black with white legs and white wings. Adult abdominifly and all stages of this tiny insect are sluggish. Female can lay up to 60 eggs under her life. Eggs are inserted singly into fruit or the upper of or lower leaf surface. eggs hatch in about 4 to 5 weeks during summer, longer during winter. And hatched eggs gradually increase in size, causing a swelling in leaf cuticle and can be seen with a hand lens. Tonight material is about controlling pests in avocado.
The first is controlling Amorbia or Western avocado leaf laurel. Biological control. Birds, predators, insect, and spider commonly prey on caterpillars. Predators include assassin bugs, damsel bugs, lacewing, and pirate bugs. A naturally occurring nuclear polyhidrosis virus often kills many Amorbia when caterpillar number become high. The caterpillar pathogen Bacillus thuringiensis is commercially available as a selective insecticide. Parasites, especially flies, family Tachinidae, are the most important natural enemies that usually keep Amorbia numbers below economically damaging level. The next is cultural control. Prune to reduce foliage touching among adjacent tree and to minimize dead twig and plant debris accumulation in canopies. Thin or selectively harvest fruit in clusters. Pruning and thinning reduce protected sites and canopy bridge that facilitates insect movement between trees, thereby reducing the abundance of caterpillar, greenhouse thrip, and mealybugs. Control wedge near avocado that host these caterpillars. Next. The next is controlling Citrotrips persei. Biological control. Natural enemies may suppress avocado thrips, but sometimes do not reduce number below damaging level. Predator thrips are the most important natural enemies, especially Franklinothrips oryzapensis. At mild temperatures about 77 Fahrenheit, F. oryzapensis density can increase readily if avocado thrips number are increasing. The predator also eats other thrips, mites and whiteflies, and feeds on avocado pollen and leaf juice. Franklinothrips, Pespiformis, Black Hunter thrips, Leptothrips mali, and several banded wing thrips, Aeolothrips sp, also feed on avocado thrips, other pest thrips and mites. Other general predator, especially green lacewing, and the last one, parasitoids, Geranisus manes, also attack avocado thrips. Next is cultural control. Avocado thrips damage is influenced by parties in that increase or decrease the abundance of succulent foliage during set and growth of young fruit. Modifying fertilization, amount, application method, formulation and timing, and pruning. Adding coarse organic mulch beneath trees and maintaining a mulch layer 6-inch each may reduce survival of avocado thrips that drop from trees to pupae. Next. The next is controlling greenhouse thrips, heliothrips, Haemorrhoidalis. The first is biological control. An important egg parasite, Megapragma mimaripene family Trichogammatidae, often kills about 25 to 15 of greenhouse thrips eggs in coastal avocado. Tripobius semiluteus family Eulopidae attacks second instar larva. The normally yellow to with this thrips larvae turn black and swell around the head when a larva of this plastic webs mature inside. The Tripobius eggs to adult development time is about 3 weeks, then when temperatures average 70 Fahrenheit. Thrips number decline when about 60% of larvae are parasites. The next is cultural control. The earlier the harvest, the less thrips damage on harvested fruits. Early harvest about June or July of all mature fruit on infested trees also reduce damage to next season crops, especially on hass, where a large proportion of greenhouse thrip feed and breed on fruit. Early harvest minimize the top crop overlap period, reducing the number of thrips that can move from old to new fruit. Next. Main pest in cocoa. Next.
Hello, Peltis SPP is one of the main pests of cocoa that is found in almost all provinces in Indonesia. There are more than one species of Peltis that attacks cocoa plants, namely H. antoni, H. eivora, and H. clavifer. Nymphs and imago attack young fruit by inserting their mouth parts into the tissue, then sucking the fruit inside. While sucking the liquid, the ladybug also secretes a toxic liquid that can kill the tissue cells around the puncture. In addition to fruit, this pest also attacks young shoots and leaves. The second one is cocoa fruit borer or Conopomorpha. Cromerella. Conobola cranemerella attack of cocoa plants in almost all major cocoa producing areas in Indonesia. This pest attacks fruit that is still young to reap fruit. This pest attack can cause a decrease in cocoa fruit production by more than 80%. Larva and caterpillar which attack that cocoa pods measuring 3 cm until they are ripe. The larva damage the fruit by eating the pulp, creating channels to the seeds, causing the seeds to stick together, black in color, smaller in size, and small in size so that the quality of the seeds is low. The next one is controlling pests in cocoa. Controlling Helioptis SPP. To control Helioptis, this can be done in several ways, including using the black ant, Dolichoderus thoracicus. Black ants disrupt the Helioptis SPP. These ants on the surface of the fruit cause Helioptis so that they cannot lay eggs or suck fruit because they are attacked by these ants. In addition to black ants, this pest control can also be done by using paper ants, which are red brown in color. This pest control can also be done by using the fungi Bovaria bassiana. The isolate used was BBY725 with a dose of 25 to 50 grams of spore per hectare. With this spraying Helioptis, will die after 2 to 5 days. Several botanical pesticides can be used to control Helioptis, including tobacco leaves and sorrel leaves. The second one is controlling cocoa fruit borer. CFB pest control can be carried out in several ways, including sanitation, pruning, frequent harvesting, fertilization, and sheathing, and biological control. Sanitation is carried out on newly harvested infected fruit by peeling the infected fruit into a hole in the ground and then covering it with 20 cm thick soil. The biological control can be done using predator ants, the fungi Bovaria bassiana, and the egg parasitoid Trichogrammatoideae, increasing the population of ants. Especially black ants can be done by placing folds of dried coconut leaves and dried cocoa leaves and colonies of mealybugs. The third is chemical control of cocoa pod borer can be done by applying contact or systemic insecticides for active ingredients such as procoxar, deltametrin, cihalotrin, cipermetrin, bifenthrin, esfenfalerate, betactin, flutrin. This for our presentation. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your attention. All your question can be sent through the WhatsApp group. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.